Ericsson has always said it would play a role in the Open RAN sector when the time was right. And that time appears to be now, as it has an interesting new product announcement to share. To find out more about this, I'm talking today with Justin Paul, Senior Solutions Marketing Manager, OSS at Ericsson. So, Justin, can you tell us about the new product? And then we'll chat again after you've shared all of the salient details. So, over to you.
Thanks, Ray. Today, Ericsson's announcing the launch of the Intelligent Automation Platform. The Intelligent Automation Platform is Ericsson's implementation of the O-RAN Alliance's Service Management and Orchestration Entity, or SMO. And this is in line with the O-RAN Alliance architecture. The Intelligent Automation Platform is an important part of our story around the evolution of radio access networks. In addition to significant functionality around automation and orchestration, the Intelligent Automation Platform includes a non-real-time radio intelligent controller, or RIC. It supports an open R1 interface, and it's designed to run Ericsson, communication service provider, and other third-party R apps. And we see this as a single pane of glass for the intelligent automation of any mobile network. The platform also includes an R app software development toolkit, or an SDK. The SDK is an important part of the launch because this is the toolkit that enables easy and rapid development of R apps by anybody. The kit contains interfaces, APIs, instructions, automated test kits, and perhaps most importantly, template applications, which really help you build new apps quickly and efficiently. Ericsson's using this SDK to actually fly our own jets, and we've ported and upgraded some of our existing network deployment and network optimization apps to become R apps. In addition to our new R apps, you're going to hear from software companies InfoVista and Viavi about what they're doing in this space and the R apps they plan to launch in the near future. So what's unique about Ericsson's vision is that we extend service management and orchestration functionality beyond just Open RAN to handle RAN automation and orchestration across Ericsson purpose-built networks, third-party purpose-built networks, and any Cloud RAN or Open RAN network technology. The Ericsson Intelligent Automation Platform supports open O1, O2, A1, and R1 interfaces. And this means the Ericsson Intelligent Automation Platform is open, it's multi-vendor, and it's multi-technology, by which we mean it supports both Open RAN technologies and existing 4G and 5G purpose-built RAN technologies. The benefit of this approach is that you don't need multiple SMOs in your network, one for each RAN vendor or each technology type. And this is absolutely key for decreasing complexity. It also means that whether you're an early adopter of Open RAN technologies and have enthusiastic plans for Open RAN rollout, or you're taking a more conservative approach to the technology, the Ericsson Intelligent Automation Platform supports your choice. We believe that the ability to support multiple technologies is a key enabler for the adoption of Open RAN. Another important benefit of multi-vendor, multi-technology approach is that key R apps can be deployed across the entire network, whatever your mix of technologies. Within Ericsson, we see four categories of R apps: network evolution, network deployment, network optimization, and of course, network healing. As part of the Intelligent Automation Platform announcement, we're launching a number of network optimization and network deployment R apps that demonstrate the platform's capability. These apps have been built, or in some cases, ported and upgraded using the Ericsson Intelligent Automation Platform SDK. And we call this flying our own jets. And what you'll see is many of our new R apps will be new versions of Ericsson's existing CSON and network design and optimization applications. And they're designed to work across both Open RAN technologies and existing purpose-built RAN networks. The new Ericsson R apps will run on the Intelligent Automation Platform's non-real-time RIC, which is the execution environment. But the expectation, and this is really important to the industry, is that these R apps will run on any R1 interface compliant non-real-time RIC. It means the applications are portable. In addition, we fully expect that the SDK will actually drive our app innovation, and we expect to announce new communication service providers and third-party R apps developed using our SDK in the very near future. So drilling down to the R apps we're announcing today, the three R apps are centralized 5G automatic neighbor relations, which is about establishment of cell neighbor relations based on lots of different measurements and detection parameters. But the upshot is when you put a new network component into the network and switch it on, it automatically works out what frequencies it ought to be on and how it talks to all the other cells. We've got frequency layer management, and this is an intent-based improvement of user experience by balancing traffic between different frequency layers. And last, but by no means least, we've got performance diagnostics. This is an AI-powered automatic cell issue classification and root cause analysis function, and it provides RAN performance improvement across the entire RAN network architecture. So that's it in a nutshell. We're announcing the launch of our new intelligent automation platform, an open, multi-vendor, multi-technology service management and orchestration platform for intelligently automating and orchestrating any mobile network. The platform has a comprehensive SDK, and we're also announcing our initial field-proven R apps, with the expectation of more R apps to come, both from Ericsson and third parties. So that's it. Thank you very much.
Okay, great. Thanks, Justin. A really interesting development there. Can you talk about what is different about this service management and orchestration solution?
Yeah, I think what's different about this solution is that we've taken the SMO concept and we've extended it beyond the realms of Open RAN to address the existing purpose-built RAN networks. And why that's important is because today only about 2% of networks are Open RAN and 98% are, you know, existing purpose-built RAN networks. So by doing that, we actually provide an automation and orchestration capability across 100% of the networks today.
And why is the SDK, the Software Development Toolkit, an important part of this launch?
Yeah, the SDK is a bit of the jewel in the crown within the intelligent automation platform because it really accelerates the ability to build and deploy and monetize our apps. We're using internally within Ericsson to build our apps, and we expect service providers to take it and use it to build things to match their own circumstances. But also we expect to build an ecosystem of new developers and new partners who come into the market to build apps based on their own data sets and skills that allow them to do some really cool and innovative things in this domain. So the SDK is absolutely critical for kickstarting that ecosystem and the new developers.
Why was it important to launch a number of Ericsson R apps at the same time? And how did Ericsson decide which ones to develop first?
Thanks, Ray. I think that's a really interesting question. The true value of the intelligent automation platform comes from the R apps that run on it. And we thought it was really important that when we launched the platform, we had our apps there to prove the concept. In terms of developing our apps themselves, the ones we've gone to market with, some of that's for us flying our own jets. We've used the SDK to build and enhance new R apps and bring those to market. We've also, as you'd imagine, had conversations with customers. And some of the applications you've seen today and we'll see in the next weeks and months will be those based on conversations with customers, you know, meeting their requirements. And that's it in a nutshell. We wanted to make sure the platform had our apps to really prove the concept from day one.
Okay, excellent. Well, there's no doubt that the whole area of SMO and the RAN Intelligent Controller is absolutely critical to the development of the O-RAN ecosystem. So really interesting to hear what Ericsson is launching here today. Justin, thanks very much for joining us and sharing what Ericsson is doing. Thank you.
Thanks, Ray. Always a pleasure.